Kai, tell us about Just Kitchen. You've tapped into that digital meal delivery industry, otherwise known as ghost kitchens. What are they? How does it work?
Ghost kitchens is a new concept really around delivery-only restaurant brands. So rather than having a physical retail store, ghost kitchens allow restaurant brands to actually serve and sell food, but you don't actually need a traditional retail restaurant to do it. You order on apps, and the food gets delivered to you, in Just Kitchen's case, within 20 minutes, hot and fresh. And it's a hybrid model that's kind of the best of both worlds.
Take us through the numbers. Why did you decide that this is the time to take Just Kitchen public?
We've been super excited about this concept for many years now, and Just Kitchen has grown really fast. This year, our revenue run rate is going to be $15 million, USD, and growing very, very quickly. A lot of it thanks to the pandemic and people really just choosing to eat at home where things are safer. It's a really fast growth business. We have 13 hubs in Taipei. The company is headquartered or based in Canada, but it's really operating out of Taiwan right now and Southeast Asia. So Taipei is where we have the most hubs. Taiwan, there are 13 ghost kitchens where we operate out of. And we'll be expanding this year to Hong Kong and Singapore. And we're looking at the US market as well. So it's really exciting times.
Tell us a little bit more about expansion plans. You're in Canada, then you're headed to the US. What's next?
We started sort of operations here in Taiwan. The team is based here. The founders are based here in Taiwan. And Southeast Asia was a market that we felt was underdeveloped and still had a lot of potential. So this is where we want to start. As I mentioned, expansion has been fast. It's really only been about a year since Just Kitchen has started business and has started offering restaurant brands online. So we're looking at quick expansion, international markets, Southeast Asia first, where we have a good footprint, and then very quickly in the US, where we believe the market opportunity there is huge and still growing very, very quickly.
Tell us about partnerships. What brands have been reaching out to you?
It's been such a sort of fast-paced growth this last year. We have a lot of brands that have reached out to us. You know, one of the important things is about two-thirds of the brands that Just Kitchen offers are in-house brands, meaning we create our own brands. Body Fit is our sort of healthy meal brand. There's a chicken brand. There's a beef noodle soup brand. But we also partner with established restaurant brands. So there are two restaurants in Taipei right now that have Michelin stars that we're working with, Three Coins and Orchid. And we're also partnered with TGI Fridays. So I think, it's this mix of our own brands and working with some established brands that makes Just Kitchen so unique.
Tell us about how you get ahead of those consumer trends. How do you determine what the customer wants?
It's one of the things that I think that makes Just Kitchen very unique in that we spend a lot of time looking at data. And, we have 14 brands that are in-house brands. We're working with four other brands. So we have a lot of data that we can look at. And we can see, what foods do people like and what time do they like eating them. So we look at all of that data and then decide, how we actually want to open our spokes, our restaurants, our ghost kitchens. Where do we want to open them? Where do we think the real business opportunities are? A lot of it is just really around understanding our customer and understanding the data.
Is this a pandemic trend, or do you see it continuing post-pandemic, this whole digital meal delivery industry?
Yeah, I think this sort of digital meal delivery, online food delivery, is here to stay. I think it got accelerated by the pandemic and COVID-19. but the behaviors are established, right? I think we see a lot of people wanting, and in fact, in many ways, preferring to order their food rather than traditionally having to go out to a restaurant. And you know, a lot, you waste a lot of time. Not only is it safer now to have food delivered, but you know, you also save a lot of time. So the trend is clearly here to stay. And you know, at Just Kitchen, we're going to continue to push that, more brands, more ghost kitchens out there, and expanding into more territories.
Let's go backwards a little bit, if you will. Some of the lessons that you learned in your previous life, you were one of the names behind, I guess, one of the most influential video games, I want to say, probably of our time, Guitar Hero. What did you learn from there that you can apply here?
I was very lucky to have been part of Guitar Hero. My brother and I co-founded the company. And really, I think one of the learnings that we took is understanding the consumer. You know, what do they want? What are they interested in? And with Guitar Hero, I was really trying to listen to the consumer, understand, hey, music games was an area that was underserved, but, you know, young, old, male, female, everybody likes music, and everybody, you know, really enjoyed playing those type of games. And so, you know, we were lucky to have found a winning formula in Guitar Hero. I think that's the kind of thing that we want to take into Just Kitchen, where, you know, we really understand the consumer, we understand what their eating preferences are, what their habits are, and perhaps even predict where we think they want to go. And so that's a big part of the learning from what I've done before.
So where do you see those trends headed? How do you avoid that crash and burn?
I think, you know, the great thing about food is we all have to eat, right? That's never going to stop. And so it's really about trying to figure out what consumers' tastes are, where are they headed? And we know consumer tastes will change over time. And so we have these unique brands that we're offering and that we're creating. And what we want to do is keep updating and refreshing those, just like any other traditional brick and mortar restaurant brand has to do. They have to keep their menu fresh. They want to bring in, you know, not only their existing customers, but you want to bring in new customers. And so at Just Kitchen, that's one of the things that we're constantly tweaking and changing, just making sure we're staying ahead of the consumer, you know, sort of interests and preferences, and really trying to offer them something that is of value and that they value a lot.
Kai, is the dream ultimately acquisition?
You know, I think it's probably a little bit too early to think in those terms. You know, right now we're just focused on hyper growth. Clearly, you know, if that opportunity comes along and it's the right opportunity, it's definitely something we'll consider. But, you know, it's still such a new category. This category of food delivery really hasn't been around more than 5 or 6 years. And we think that the runway is huge. We think there's a huge opportunity, not only in creating restaurant brands, right, new food brands, but we also think that there's still a lot of growth regionally in a lot of different territories. So I think the opportunity is huge. I think we got a really long runway. So we're not quite thinking about exits and that yet, but we're just really focused on hyper growth at this point.